Did you receive your first telescope and you are wondering how to play with it? I will show you the first very basic steps a beginner should take when in contact for the first time with a telescope. But if you already are an experienced user, stay with us because I have a nice tip for you later in the video. One of the first silly things I did, and probably you will do once in a while, it's to forget to take off the cap of the telescope. So you have a cap on the top of the telescope and you have to take it out to watch through the telescope. If you forget to do that, you will see all dark. You want to avoid straight light when placing the telescope. For instance, neighbor's light, street LED lights, or any other intrusive light that you have around you should be avoided. So place it in the best way possible. The telescope I'm using for this demonstration is an 8-inch Dobsonian telescope, which I love and it's very user-friendly. You have many of them in AstroArt Finland, our sponsor. The movement is very simple, it's just up, down, left and right, which they called alt-azimuth movements. Altitude up and down, azimuth left and right. But you want those movements to be smooth. To control the azimuth movement, the left and right, you have a knob at the base of the telescope you want to tighten if the telescope is moving too fast. However, you don't want to tighten it too much because like that it will be difficult for the telescope to move. So try to feel the movement. Connect with your telescope. Move it left and right slowly and see a smooth movement. But you want the same smoothness to the altitude bearings. So you will do the same, but now with the two knobs. They are at the left and at the right of the rocker. You will tighten them just enough to have a smooth movement up and down. Again, feel the movement, feel the telescope. At the end, you will move left and right, up and down, and you will know, feeling that the movement is the correct movement. If your telescope doesn't have the knobs and instead have some springs, just lock the springs and use it as is. In these situations, there are tricks to have a good balance of the tube. I talk about that in another video. It's very important to have a commitment with your telescope. One thing that I do a lot, and this is a tip not only for beginners but also for advanced users, is to be sitting around the telescope and just watching the telescope and thinking, put your neurons working. If you're a beginner, you will think how the telescope works, how the light enters, how it bumps on the primary mirror, etc, etc. And the experienced guys and girls can think in ways to improve and things that you can do with your telescope. What to upgrade, what will benefit you, what you will see tonight in the sky, and so on. When practicing this exercise, not only you increase the commitment with your telescope, but also your brain will work much better in a positive way, which will benefit you and your connection with the universe. Probably the eyepieces that came with your telescope are a 10mm eyepiece and a 25mm eyepiece. Start with a 25. It will give you a larger field of view, so you will see more stars, but more distant. Therefore, more tiny. But that's easier to do. Take the caps off the eyepiece, don't touch with the fingers in the lenses, and insert the eyepiece into the focuser. Tighten the focuser screw in order to have the eyepiece fixed. And now pay attention how to move the telescope. To move left and right, you grab the top of the telescope and place the end more or less at the middle of the tube. And with the left end at the top, you move left and right, nice and steady. And to move the telescope up and down, you will use the same left hand. However, this time the right hand at the middle of the tube will help you to give some weight when moving the telescope up. To move it down is easier because of the gravity. This is the best way and the simpler way to move this telescope. A common mistake that beginners do sometimes, though, is to grab the eyepiece or the focuser with the left hand and move the telescope with it. It happens because when we are watching an object, we tend to place the hand at the focuser. And then to move, as the hand is already there, we force to move the telescope. But that's wrong. Get used to use the hand at the top of the telescope. But there's much more you need to know to move on. For instance, it's very important to know how to properly focus your telescope. That's why you should click on this video over here to learn how to do that in a keep it simple way.